Once upon a time, there's a dog named Pochi. Pochi was alone and hungry in the middle of rain. Suddenly, he saw a house. Pochi knocked the door and a grandpa came out. Pochi asked for food, but the grandpa felt disturbed. He became angry and chased Pochi away. Pochi ran away sadly and he continued his walk. Not long after that, he saw another house. Pochi knocked the door and a grandma came out. The grandma felt sorry and asked Pochi to come in. Inside, there's a kind grandpa. The grandpa wiped Pochi's body, and the grandma gave Pochi some food to eat. The next day, Pochi walked diligently as his gratefulness to the old couple. The old couple who have no child really loved Pochi like their own child. One day, when the grandpa was walking on the field, Pochi barked suddenly as he pointed somewhere, asking the grandpa to dig it. The grandpa confused with how Pochi was acting, but since Pochi was stopped barking, the grandpa agreed and dug it, and gold pieces jumped out from the hole. Since the gold is too much, the old couple decided to share the gold to their neighbor. Seeing that, the bad grandpa who lived next door wasn't happy. Bad grandpa took Pochi forcefully from kind grandpa. Kind grandpa was very shocked and tried to hold Pochi back. But bad grandpa tied up Pochi's neck quickly and pulled him to the field. Bad grandpa forced Pochi to show him the gold location. Pochi was terrified and he started sniffing with sad face. But the bad grandpa took Pochi was showing the gold location and start digging. But bad grandpa was really shocked because there's only trash jump out from the hole. There was no gold at all. Bad grandpa was really mad. He hit Pochi until he died. The next day, the worried kind grandpa came to bad grandpa house to ask Pochi's condition. Bad grandpa told kind grandpa that he had killed Pochi. Kind grandpa was really surprised. Then he asked for Pochi's dead body and he brought it home. The grandma who waited for grandpa to come home was also surprised. They were really sad and they buried Pochi in their garden. They really regret that they let Pochi go. After that, they plant a tree in Pochi's grave and they raise it as Pochi's substitute. Day by day, the tree grew really fast. One day, the tree fell down because of a thunder. The old couple really sad because they lost Pochi tree. The grandpa then make a mochi mortar from the fallen tree. The old couple start making mochi with the mortar. Then, a miracle happened. When grandpa pawned his hammer, pieces of gold came out from it. They really surprised and thanked Pochi. Since the gold is too much, they shared it again to their neighbor. The bad grandpa felt annoyed. He came to the kind old couple and borrowed Pochi mortar. He took it home and started making mochi. But again, there's only trash came out from it. The bad grandpa was really angry. He smashed down the mortar and made it into firewood. The next morning, kind grandpa came to bad grandpa's house to ask him to return Pochi mortar. But the bad grandpa only said that he had burned down the mortar and there's only ash left. Kind grandpa was very shocked. Then he collected the ash into a basket and went home. In his way to home, suddenly a wind blew away the ash in his basket. Magically, when the ash touched a dead tree, cherry blossoms start blooming from the tree. Then he climbed into the tree and start spreading the ash to make Pochi happy. Not long after that, a nobleman passed by. The nobleman was really happy and amazed by the cherry blossoms that grown by the grandpa. The nobleman then gave him a lot of presents. Again, the bad grandpa felt envy with that. He took a lot of ash from kind grandpa, climbed a tree, and waited for the nobleman. When the nobleman passed by, he started throwing the ash. Unfortunately, a wind caught the ash and blew it into the nobleman's eyes. The nobleman was really angry. He commanded his guard to catch bad grandpa and throw him into the jail. Meanwhile, the old couple spread the rest ash into Pochi's grave. And magically, a tree bud popped up from the ground. Since then, the old couple lived happily ever after without ever forget about Pochi.